Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. We were expecting a Starlink launch during the week and SpaceX had posted this tweet. They said, static fire test of Falcon 9 complete, targeting Friday, November 18th for launch of 52 Starlink satellites to orbit from SLC-4E in California. However, on Thursday, they also posted another tweet about this Starlink mission. They said, standing down from tomorrow's launch of Starlink to take a closer look at data from static fire will announce a new target launch date once confirmed. There were a couple of other launch-related tweets posted by SpaceX. This one says, targeting Tuesday, November 22nd at 3:54 p.m. Eastern Time for Falcon 9's launch of Dragon's 26th commercial resupply mission to the space station. The next one says, targeting Monday, November 21st at 9:57 p.m. Eastern Time for a Falcon 9 launch of the Eutelsat 10B mission from SLC-40 in Florida. Jeff Faust posted information related to the delay of the CRS-26 mission. It says, SpaceX's Sarah Walker says they found a leak in the spacecraft's thermal control system isolated to a single flange. It has been repaired but put preparations about a shift behind, hence the one-day delay. There was a tweet posted about Crew Dragon. It says SpaceX finally confirms today on the CRS-26 pre-launch news conference that they'll build a fifth Crew Dragon spacecraft. There was an article about SpaceX posted that I want to share. In short, it says charges filed with federal regulators accuse the company of retaliating against 8 workers over an open letter critical of the chief executive. There was information about SpaceX job postings. This article says SpaceX is hiring engineers to work on next-generation Starlink technology at its Redmond, Washington facility. According to one job listing on SpaceX's website, the company is looking to hire specialists for its Starlink Solar 2 team that will work on solar stringer machines. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the Orbital launch site. Some new cladding has been seen added to the Orbital launch tower. There was methane spotted delivered to the launch site. Here's a view of a new tent being constructed at the production site. This new test tank was spotted outside the midbay. Work continues on the Ship 24 prototype sitting on the test mount. Taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, there was no more testing last week. Originally, there were possible closures for this week, but both were cancelled. So as of now, the next closures are next week with Monday 28th, Tuesday 29th and Wednesday 30th. As always, I have to say thanks to Chris Kleindl for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.